Good day from Chem Help ASAP. I'm excited for this video because we are going to learn a new way to communicate structure, and this is a shorthand method that almost all chemists use to draw their organic structures. It's very efficient and quick. It's called line angled notation. Sometimes people call them skeletal structures, but I call them line angle structures. So what are the rules for this method of communication? Well, first of all, we don't label our carbon atoms. That's a time saver. Number two, we don't label our hydrogen atoms. That's also a time saver, at least the hydrogen atoms on our carbon atoms. And number three, lone pair electrons are typically not shown. Let's see how this translates into a structure. So on the bottom left, we have isopropanol. Isopropanol, it is not a huge molecule to draw, but it takes some time to draw out that structure. So let's see what it looks like as a line angle structure. That's it. That is isopropanol as a line angle structure. So let's number our carbons on our Lewis structure, 1, 2, and 3. And let's number the corresponding carbons over on the right-hand structure. So that carbon 1 is at the end of this line. So that line ends at an atom. It's unlabeled, so it must be a carbon. Now the thing is, how do you know how many hydrogens that carbon has? Well, we've shown one bond for this carbon. It's that bond right there. It's between carbon 1 and carbon 2. Carbon typically makes 4 bonds. So that carbon 1, still needs 3 bonds. What are those bonds to? Well, they must be to the hydrogens. And step 2 says we don't have to label those, so we don't have to write those in. But that carbon 1, that is a CH3. Now, let's go to carbon 2. Carbon 2 is shown with 3 bonds. 1 to carbon 1, 1 to the oxygen, and a third bond to carbon 3. That's 3 bonds. It needs 4 bonds. That fourth bond must be to an unshown hydrogen. Carbon 3 is much like carbon 1. That is shown with 1 bond. That must have 3 additional bonds there to hydrogens, which aren't shown. That's a CH3. And then finally, carbon 2 is bonded to an oxygen. Now, notice on the oxygen, we did put in the hydrogen. We wrote in the hydrogen. That's because you must put in hydrogens if they're not on carbon. So the OH is required. We don't have to draw it as a bond coming off, but we have to put that H on there. Now, oxygen should have 2 lone pairs to give it a full octet. Rule 3, we're not required to show lone pairs. So this is a minimal structure. It's a very quick and efficient way to communicate molecular structure. We're going to draw some pretty big molecules, a lot bigger than isopropanol, and we need a more efficient way to communicate. Now let's go to a simpler molecule on the right. This is propane. And let's think about how we might draw propane as a line angle structure. You might think, well, I could draw a line. And let's number our carbons up here first. I could draw a line, and that would be carbon 1, and that would be carbon 2. And then let's just continue our line, and that would be carbon 3. Now the problem is, it's hard to tell, is this a line that has an atom in it, or am I really just drawing a line, and there's carbon 1 and carbon 2? And so the reader won't know what you mean. To get around this, what people do is they tend to put zigzags in their chains. And so here's a line that starts with carbon 1, it goes up to carbon 2, and then comes back down, and that's carbon 3. And there's our CH3 carbon 1, CH2 carbon 2, CH3 carbon 3. So there's the angle part of these line angle structures. We tend to write zigzags so it's clear where there's a carbon and where we continue on to a new atom. Without those zigzags, we just draw straight lines, and you couldn't tell, is that 4 carbons or 5 carbons? It all just looks like a straight line. So that's a very quick introduction to the idea of line angle structures, and we will use these continuously in our organic course.